under Companies Act. So then only people can start the business. So the disadvantages will be of a partnership will be overcome by these joint stock companies. So here, is there any limit of members in this company to join? So the person who is going to join in the invest in the company is called as what? Shareholder. So that means share means here a part of capital which is holded by a particular investor or particular person. So to that extent, that person will become the shareholder because he is holding the share of the capital. He is called as what? Shareholder. So these shareholders may hold to the extent of their capability. Okay? Capability of investment. So there is no limited, even 10 rupees also the person can invest in a business. So if the face value of the share is 10 rupees, you can invest 10 rupees. And you can become one of the partner of that particular business. So all these shareholders will become the partners of the business. We have different types of shareholders that we will see how many types are there. But here, this capital of this company will be issued to different people, those who are interested to invest in the business, who are called as what? Shareholders. Joint stock means here unlimited members will be having the they are going to hold the stock of the company jointly. Stock means here shares. Shares will be holded by all the people. All these people are called as what? Shareholders. So there is no limit to that a person can hold the capital of the business or not to hold the capital of the business. Okay. So these shareholders may be unlimited. And whenever they are interested to join, invest in the business, they can invest. Otherwise, they can leave. Okay. So let us see, you can understand in detail when we go for different features of this, characteristics of this joint stock company. So if we are going to see the features, features are nothing but the characteristics, or it can be also be called as what? Nature of joint stock company. So different characteristics will be there. So one, it is compulsory incorporation. So that means when this company is going to be registered in Companies Act, under Companies Act at the registration office. So compulsory, they have to get a certificate, which is called as what? Certificate of incorporation. So certain documents should be submitted by the promoters. Promoters means nothing but the persons who are going to start the business. Initial starters of the company are called as what? Promoters. So these promoters will be providing certain documents to the registration office of company. So that company's registration office will check these documents. Documents means we can say that one, it is memorandum of association. Memorandum of association, one document. And the second document, it is articles of association. So these two documents should be submitted to register your company. So if the registrar is going to be satisfied with this documents which were submitted by the promoters, then only they will issue a certificate, which is called as certificate of incorporation. If this incorporation certificate is earned by the company, then only they are eligible to start the company. Otherwise, they are not eligible to start the company. So what all these documents are, what is the information that you have to give, that we will see in the coming classes in detail. But here, that certificate of incorporation is must to start a business. So this is one of the character that it is required to start a company. Is that clear? So that is what it is, a feature called as what? Compulsory incorporation. So incorporation is one of the certificate. And this joins the company is an artificial person. So we will treat the company as an person, but it is not the real person. It is an artificial person. So why we are calling it as a person means whatever the decision that was taken by the company, that is treated as whether it should be followed or whether it should not be followed by the shareholders. So they are why we are saying that it is artificial person means they will be having a seal. So based on the seal, if there is a seal on any decision making, that indicates that the company has decided. So to get that seal also, it is very difficult to a company. Without this certificate of incorporation, they cannot have that particular seal. Okay, so that seal indicates that it is the person who has decided. So whatever the circular or any decision that was taken by the company management, so with the seal, if any circular is circulated, that indicates that that should be followed by everyone. Okay, that should be taken as a person is saying that these rules and regulations they have to follow. So like that it indicates. So we will treat that joint stock company as an artificial person. As you can take this our college seal will be there, no? There will be a stamp at the end which the principal is going to give at the end of any circular like that, and there will be signature of the head of the department, right? That means head of the organization. So in the same manner, a company will also have a seal, and that will be signed by the top management, and that should be followed by each and everyone. Okay, so that common seal is required. So if that seal is there on any document or on any paper, that indicates that that was decided by that top person of that particular organization or company. Okay, so company's seal itself will be indicating that should be whatever the information that was given, and this should be followed by each and everyone. And another characteristic is here, perpetual succession. I will discuss in detail about all these things. So first I will list out all the characteristics. And the liability is limited liability. As we have seen in partnership and sole proprietorship, there is unlimited liability. Here only the liability is limited. Limited means here, what extent you have invested, to that extent only you are liable to pay to the third party. Your own property will not be taken over. And there will be share capital, and the owner will be separated. Owner's capital is different, and the company's capital will be different. Separation will be, their ownership will be different, and the company will be different. And it is an legal entity because you have registered. So your company, against your company, any third person can take legal action, or the company can take any legal action against any person who has cheated the company. Okay, legal entity will be there. That means here registration is compulsory, and due to registration, legal actions will be taken here. And there will be large membership. There is no limit of members, those who want to join in the company as an investor. So all these are the different characteristics of joint stock company. Let us see in detail about the each and every characteristic. So as I have told you that it is a compulsory incorporation. So this is going to be voluntary association of persons. So that means they are not going to be forced to join in the organization. And they need to get the incorporation certificate under the Companies Act. So then only they can start the business. Those who are interested to start a business and those who are having idea, they can go and get this certificate of incorporation and they can start the company. Unless they are going to get this certificate of incorporation, they cannot start the company. Okay, so artificial person, as we have said that this company is going to be an artificial person created by law because you have registered under the Companies Registration Act. So by law, this company will be treated as an artificial person. So everything that was done by the company on behalf of company, any person is going to act, everything will be taken as legally it is accepted. Okay, and that legal process will be created, and this will be having an starting of the company. Okay, so once the legally company's registration is done, that means whenever you get the certificate of incorporation, the legal process will be started, created. Okay, that means the birth of the company has been taken. So once you are an once the company is an artificial person, it can enter into contracts, it can sue against any person, and it is going to have own property to the extent of the capital that was invested, and it can appoint the employees, and it can borrow money from any other natural person also, any other individual. Natural person means individual. So because legally they are having right to do all these things. Like a person, this company will do everything as a sole proprietor or a partnership is going to do. All those things this company can do as a natural person. Okay. But it is an artificial person. And the common seal, as we have said, that company is going to have, it is an artificial person. So it has no physical features, no, like a person is having anything. So it cannot it cannot sign on the papers, no. So this common seal will indicate that it is the signature of that artificial person. If that common seal is not there, whoever is going to sign on the any circular, it is not valid, that it is not related with the company. If a signature with a seal is there, that indicates that the company is going to it was circulated by the company itself, artificial person itself. Okay, so any natural person signing on any company's circulars will not be valid until a common seal is there on that particular paper. So that is what it is, a common seal is having that much of importance in the company. So if this common seal is there, then only you can go for suing against the company according to law. then only law will be applicable. Without common sense, you cannot take any action against the company. So this common seal will be serving as an natural person signature. As a natural person is going to sign on anything, so in that manner this common seal will be helping the company. So it can be seal can be on all important documents or contracts. So it is going to be witness that the company has gone through these documents or contracts, and this should be a common seal should be witnessed by two directors. Okay, signature of two directors. Already they will be having a board of directors will be there now. So that among that team, two directors should sign on that contracts. And a counter signature should be done by the secretary. So if it is required, only the secretary will be signing. Otherwise, if two directors are going to sign on any important documents or on any contracts that was undergone by the joint stock company, that indicates that it is related with the company. So that witness is required here. So this common seal, everyone cannot use this common seal. That will be under the custody of directors only. Not the common employees will not have that common seal. And another feature, it is perpetual succession. So as we have said that the company is separate from the individuals. Individuals means like any members or directors or employees who are related with the company. So it is separated from all these people. So even though they are their death takes place, or if they are insolvent, insolvent means not able to pay the amount, all these things takes place, then we cannot say that the company is going to end. As we have seen in the partnership, the dissolution will take place whenever a partner is going to die, right? If his death takes place, one of the partner's death takes place, what happens? The partnership business will be closed, right? So in that manner, you cannot close the company. So even any member is going to die or director is going to die, it won't affect the running of the business, running of the company. So that is what we will say, that perpetual succession. Perpetual succession means continuity. There will be continuity of the company even any unforeseen conditions takes place to any of the member, director or employees. It exists forever. So to close that, again you need to go to the registration office and you have to follow certain rules and regulations. You have to submit certain documents. Then only the joint stock company can be closed. Until that formality is done, that company will not be closed. Okay, so that is what it is, an perpetual succession. Continuity of the company. See, under Provision Act only this company can be closed. Otherwise, you cannot close the company. So for the closing of the company also, you have to go through so many formalities. Then only the company can be closed. Otherwise, it cannot be closed. So, and the limited liability, as we have said, whatever the amount that was invested in the company, to that extent only the members are liable to pay to the outsiders. Their personal cannot be taken over by anyone. and the share capital, how this they are going to get the share capital, how they are going to raise the share capital. Capital, instead of saying that it is capital, we are saying that it is share capital. Why? Because this whole amount of capital will be splitted into small parts of capital, and that will be issued to the public or to the individual. Whoever is interested, they can hold that particular share. Okay, that may be 10 rupees, 100 rupees, based on the face value they have decided. How many parts they want to divide the whole capital, they will be dividing. Okay, so to that extent of amount, the investor, whoever is interested, he can hold that, he can invest in that. Like that, the company can raise whenever they require capital, they can raise from the public. Okay, so initially, if you are going to issue the shares, that is called as IPO. IPO means initial public offer. Initial public offer. That means, so without having any share capital, or if they want a new capital that should be in the company that they require. So then what they are going to do is they are going to raise some more share capital from the public by issuing this initial public offer. So this will be in primary markets, these share capital can be raised. They are going to issue these shares in the primary market. We will have two types of markets. One, it is primary market, and the second one is secondary market. Primary market means directly they are going to issue to the individuals or the investors. A secondary market means where you can sell your shares and you can buy any shares. Already IPOs, through IPOs, whatever the share capital that was raised and they have issued shares, no? So all those shares can be purchased and sold in the secondary market. Okay, secondary market means you can take everyone is aware of this, stock markets, stock exchanges will be there now, where in the stock exchanges only you can sell your shares in the stock exchanges, which you have purchased from the IPOs. And you can purchase from the stock exchanges any other capital. So if any person is going to sell his shares, that can be purchased by any other investor. Okay, there in stock exchanges, they are not going to issue the IPOs. That is the only thing difference you have to keep in mind. IPOs cannot be issued in stock exchanges. Okay. So whatever the amount they require, they are going to raise their capital from this stock exchanges or IPOs, and they need to raise the share capital. Also, everyone cannot do that. They need to submit certain documents to the registration office, company's registration office, and they have to get acknowledge from that particular registration office, and then only they can issue the shares. And what type of shares they are going to issue, everything they have to mention in those documents while submitting to the registration office. And these shareholders, whoever is going to hold the shares, they will become the owners, and they can transfer to any other person. There is no restriction like partnership or sole proprietorship. That ownership cannot be transferred. Okay, so if you don't want to hold that shares, you can sell that in the stock exchanges, and you can be free from the ownership of that particular shares. So to any person, there is no restriction that you have to sell these shares to only a particular person. Who is going to purchase also you don't know in the stock exchanges, but you will sell it. Okay, like that a transfer will be taking place. And ownership will be different and the capital will be different. So even though promoters are there, those who are the starters of the business, so initially they will invest some capital, of course. Once that company was registered, ownership is separated from the management. Okay, so the management will be based on the elections, and certain directors will be elected by the shareholders, and they will become the management of the company. But they are the representatives of the company. So these management will be having right to take every day-to-day affairs of the company. Then even though you are the promoters, you are not allowed to enter into any day-to-day affairs of the company. Only that will be decided by the director. So these directors may take the help of the managers or employees who are in the management. When different positions will be there, no, top level, middle level, like that. So they are going to create the structure, company structure. So whoever is the management position, so their help these directors will be taking, and they are going to take decisions related with the company. And there will be division of labor also. That means each and every work will be separated, like production department, finance department, like that. Each and every work will be splitted, because it is a very big, large company, no? Everything cannot be holded or handled by a particular group. So what they are going to do is they are going to delegate their rights to their subordinates, and they will give to some extent rights to manage that particular activity or that particular specialized department. So like that, there will be division of labor will be taking place based on the specializations. And a legal entity, so by law, this will be created, no? This joint stock company. So they can exist, and they can that company can be closed based on this legal law. Companies Law Act will be utilized here. So the particular members of that particular company cannot be held responsible. And for the acts of the company, whatever the company is going to do, that is not responsible for, that cannot be held responsible by the members. So whoever is under decision-making position, they are kept responsible for that. So whatever the members are going to act, their action or outside whatever they are going to do, that is not related with the company. And there will be large number of membership. Many members can invest. This many members can be limited to the extent of 50 members in case of private limited company. We can divide the companies into two types, private limited company and a public limited company. If it is a private limited company, then the members will be limited to, maximum members will be limited to 50. Whereas in case of public limited company, unlimited members are there. So that's all. That is what the characteristics of joint stock company.